get to pop. Some of y'all still ain't said it right. If you would, please do me a huge favor. Do me a huge favor. Please. Look at one more neighbor. This time put a note in your throat and say, neighbor. I said, say, neighbor. The fix is yet to come. Good, real quick. Acts chapter number 16, verse number 25. The preacher said, keep it 15 minutes or less. Let's do that. Let's keep it 15 minutes or less. Mm-hmm. Bible says in Acts chapter 16, number 25, verse 25, it says, and at midnight, Paul and Silas prayed and sang praises unto God. And the prisoners heard them. And suddenly, y'all ain't listening to me, let me read that one more time. Acts 16 and verse 25, it says, and at midnight, Paul and Silas prayed and sang praises unto God, and the prisoners heard them, and suddenly, you know, it's great to have a set time to pray and seek the face of God. The psalmist David, he said it like this in the 55th number of Psalms. He said, evening and morning and at noon will I pray and cry aloud. Somebody shout aloud. And he shall answer my voice. You'll also find Daniel praying three times a day. And it's great to pray. The Bible speaks on special emphasis of praying in the morning. The Bible says that at 9 o'clock a.m. it was in Acts chapter number 2 when the Holy Ghost fell on the day of Pentecost. The Bible says that the men thought that they were drunk because they had been overtaken by the Spirit of God. The Bible says that the Spirit came in and there was a sound from heaven coming in. It was a sound like a rushing mighty wind. I don't know about you all, but you got to understand, before there's a move of God, there's going to always be a sound. There's going to always be a sound from heaven. And there was a sound coming from heaven like a rushing mighty wind. The Bible said that there was cloven tongues that set upon each of them, and they began to speak in tongues as the Spirit gave them the language. Look at the neighbor real quick. Say, neighbor, have you spoken in tongues lately? Oh, caught you off guard with that one. But then there's also another instance where they were praying in the evening time around 3 o'clock. You'll find it in Acts chapter number 3. This was during the time that Peter and John, the Bible says, that it was during the hour of prayer. It was 3 o'clock in the afternoon where they met a man that was lame. The man began to beg and ask for money, and they told him that silver and gold have I none, but such as I have, I give unto thee. Even though it's great to have a set time to pray, pray in the morning, pray in the afternoon, pray in the evening times, but there's also another special moment when we should pray, people of God. Brothers and sisters, I submit to you that it's an awesome time to pray when you have revelation. Somebody shout revelation. Yes, I believe that it was Daniel that said it. Daniel, the Bible says in Daniel chapter 9, verse 2, it says during the year of King Darius, that the Bible says that Daniel, he understood by the books of Jeremiah. He understood the timing. He understood the season. He understood that the 70 years were up. And then he said, since he understood that, since he had the revelation, he turned his face and he sought the face of God. I submit to you that here Paul and Silas, the Bible doesn't say anything about what happened to them before that midnight hour. But it does tell us this within context, that they were beaten with stripes. They were beaten on their backs. They had their clothes pulled down. And they were beaten with rods on their back. Cut their backs wide open. Bleeding in their backs. Then they thrown them in the innermost part of the prison. Then the Bible said they locked them up, locked their feet up, locked their hands up. They were shackled with their hands, shackled with their feet. And for the most part, the Bible doesn't say anything from the point where they were locked up until the midnight hour. But I believe that these men of God, I believe they probably woke up in the morning and they prayed. I believe that they prayed in the noonday. I believe they probably prayed at 3 o'clock in the afternoon. But if something of God, that they came into a point when it began to approach midnight, that God began to give them a revelation, and the revelation was, hey, you're coming up on midnight. That's the end of the beginning, or the beginning of the end. Y'all ain't listening to me. So whenever there's a midnight situation, what's beginning to happen is God is getting ready to do something new for you. Look at the neighbor real quick and say, neighbor, God's going to do something new for you. Come on, look at another neighbor and say, neighbor, God's getting ready to do something new for you. So midnight is the appointed time of transition. Is there anybody going through a transition right now? Midnight is the time of transition where you're going from one day to the next day. But also it's the moment that the date changes. So midnight is also the end and it's the beginning. The Bible lets us know in Lamentations chapter number 3. He says that the Lord's, by the Lord's mercy will not consume, and his compassions, they fail not, for they are new every morning. I believe they came into the realization that, hey, we're getting on the brink of a brand new day. We're getting ready to see the compassions of the Lord. We're getting ready to see the mercies of God. Not only this, but I know y'all are familiar with this one. The Bible says it like this, that weeping may, weeping may endure for a night, but joy comes in the morning time. I know they had a revelation of that. Not only did they have a revelation of that, but they also had a revelation of this, that God, he's going to load them with daily benefits. The Bible says that he daily loads us with benefits. And if you study that scripture, and if you read the scripture real close and study other translations, it'll bring it out like this. It says that every day, God, he carries our burdens. Look at your neighbor real quick and say, neighbor, if God took you through yesterday, he's going to take you through another day. I believe they got a revelation from God. And when they got this revelation, they began to think about all the benefits. And they said, bless the Lord, oh my soul, and all that's within me. Bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, oh my soul, and forget not all of his benefits. Look at your neighbor real quick and say, neighbor. Come on, look at your neighbor and say, neighbor. Y'all ain't said nothing to your neighbor all night. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor. Have you checked out your benefits pack? Yeah, come on, tell an old neighbor, say, neighbor, have you checked out your benefits pack? Yeah, because the benefit package says this. The benefit package, it says it like this. It says that he crowns your head with loving kindness and tender mercies. It also says that he'll satisfy your mouth with good things. It also says that he'll forgive you of all your iniquities. It also says that he'll heal you of all your disease. And this is the revelation that they came in contact with, because they understood to have a set time. It's good to have a set time to pray. Because when they pray, when you have a set time, it builds up your devotion to God. Yes, it does. Not only does it build up your devotion and your dedication, but it's also good for your development. Somebody shout development. It's also good for being disciplined. The Muslims can pray 5 times a day. Guess what? The saints of God, we certainly can pray all day. Y'all ain't saying nothing. This is why we have the Holy Spirit. Because the Holy Spirit, he helps us pray. The Bible says that we know not what to pray for as we ought, but the Spirit himself makes intercession for us with groanings that cannot be uttered. Lift up your hands right, say, I'm not right now, and say, fill me, Lord. They began to pray and they began to praise God. Even though they were in pain, they began to pray and they began to praise God. Even though they were in prison, they began to pray and they praised God. Even though they were in a problematic situation, they began to pray and they praised God. Even though they were under pressure, you know, they began to pray and they began to praise God. Not just because God was going to set them free, but they were just praying to God because they had a relationship. And I'll prove it to you. They weren't praying to be released. They were just praying to commune with God. They were just blessing the Lord. See, this is the point that we got to remember here. That we got to be able to praise God before the end result. We got to be able to pray to God before everything is all over. We got to be able to give God an ovation before the outcome. We got to be able to give God exaltation before the end result. We got to be able to give God an applause before the achievement. Back all up. We got to be able to command the Lord. The proof. Look at your neighbor. Say, neighbor. shout, you're shut in. Send a shout out. I said, while you're shut in, send a shout out. Now, what does it mean to send a shout out? Shout out, I didn't have to look at my Hebrew. I didn't have to look at my Greek. But what I did, I had to look at the Urban Dictionary. Urban Dictionary says it like this, that when you give a shout out, it's a public expression of thanks and gratitude. When you give a shout out, it's to acknowledge someone, to make one's presence known. When you give a shout out, it's a positive public acknowledgement. When you give a shout out, it's to acknowledge with respect. So while you're shut in, when you shut in, it means that you're restricted. You can't do like what you want to do. Can't go on vacation like you want to. Can't eat at the restaurant that you want to eat at. Can't buy the clothes that you can. But while you shut in, you got to share a shout out. High five a neighbor real quick and say, neighbor, while you're shut in, you got to send a shout out. Hey, I say while you're shut in, you got to send a shout out. Come on, put your hands right there. The blessing. Send a shout out. That he glory in tribulations. He can praise God while he's going through. He can praise God while he's under pressure. Because he knows the tribulations. Somebody shout tribulation. Tribulation, it works perseverance. And perseverance experience. And experience hope. And hope makes us not ashamed. Don't you know, because you have hope in God. What that simply means is God is not going to let you down. Because you got hope in God. Because you got hope in God. God is not going to disappoint you. Go ahead and look at the neighbor one more time. And say, neighbor, while you're shut in. Go ahead and give God a shout out. 1, 2, 3. Oh!